Fire is the only element which cannot be polluted of our system. Air can be polluted, space can be polluted, earth and water can be polluted, but fire can never be polluted. Fire burns everything and creates ash. So that is why in our tradition, in the Nath tradition, there is a lot of importance to fire. It accepts everything, it burns everything, and only ash remains. This is exactly our life also. We do so many things and finally we become ash, or we go back to earth. We come empty-handed, we go empty-handed. So that is why there is they apply ash on the forehead, you know, as a symbolic thing. First of all, it shows detachment. It is symbolic of detachment. And second is, it reminds the person who looks at you, look here, don't be too egoistic. One day, you will become ash. So, all the ego, all the limitations, all the characteristics, identities, all kinds of emotions, everything are short-lived. They have very little duration. That is when we are existing. It all becomes nothing. And second thing is that the fire is one of the first elements that leave the body at the time of death. Body becomes cold. You know it very well, you are a doctor, so which goes where? The moment the air leaves, that the last breath happens, immediately body becomes cold. So along with the prana, the fire leaves. So fire is very well connected to the prana, last breath, and it leaves. And then the water leaves, then other elements. It takes time, but fire leaves almost instantaneously. And also fire is symbolic of truth. Means it always goes up. The flames always goes up. You know. So that is why in the Vedic time, all the offerings, even now, all the rituals are like that. All the offerings are given to the fire, saying that please take it up and deliver it to. So this is for this god, this is for another god, please take it to them. And in our pictures, in the Dattatapovan pictures, you can see various deities in the flame also. The moment you offer it, saying that this is for Lord Ganesha. There are many pictures, many images have come on the fire. So that means they accept. The entities are existing. Every variety of entities are existing. Because they are created in the consciousness. So fire has a lot of meaning and potential. And any guru of Nath tradition always keeps a fire. That fire is the extension of the fire of the stomach, the fire that burns and churns, you know, the fire that eliminates, the fire that demolishes or destroys or disintegrates. That fire is that burns karma. That fire is the friend. Is a friend. It's like yourself. The fire which is operating within you is manifested on the dhuni. So fire has a lot of value, and there are many traditions which have the same concept, where fire has a lot of value. Fire also, it warms you up, and also it symbolizes the guru. Because if you sit near the fire, you are not cold anymore. Likewise, if you sit close, if you have proximity to a very high master, you are always warm in knowledge, and you are protected. So this also is the same extension of it. The guru in the Nath tradition or Datta tradition, 80% or 90% of the work is done by the guru. Not the disciple. Disciple just surrenders, then the guru delivers. You know, so the fire symbolizes that deliverance or delivery, what you call. It's that being with the guru, you attain everything. Just being, not doing many practices. You know, you can do sufficient yoga to keep yourself healthy. You can do sufficient pranayama to keep your lungs intact. But that is not what takes you higher. What takes you higher is the proximity of the guru. the guru has appeared in your life to lift your consciousness to a different dimension, and all you do is being close to him in the consciousness plane, and that is exactly what takes you to the highest point. So fire has a lot of value in our tradition, and fire symbolizes a lot of aspects of our path existence.